Hello, in this module we will discuss the business dynamics of the world electric car market. The book, The Machine That Changed the World, is about continuous improvement, Kaizen. The historic work describes how zero defect and lean production in automotive works. Electric vehicles are by mechanical design less complex than combustion vehicles, so the hardware has a good prospect to be zero defect and lean to produce. With EVs, many improvements will be made by updating the software. For instance, the Chevy Volt has more lines of software code than the Boeing Dreamliner. But this is also risky. A bug in the software can easily stay unnoticed during development. With the computerized electronic vehicles, new functional safety norms emerged. New regulations and standards are needed to change the automotive world. Automotive products need to be perfect in their function and quality. This was a renowned problem of some early EV designs, which were not enough scrutinized. Moreover, we seem to be more forgiving with technology from the past. Although we accept that car accidents happen, an accident with an EV is still front-page news. Of course, technically unsafe and unreliable products are an unacceptable risk in traffic. Likewise, the charging infrastructure will have to meet health and safety regulations. R100 and 101 are about high voltage, ISO 26262 about electronics, and ISO 15118 about charging. Also, local homologation or European type approval is needed. And only conformity of production can guarantee that all products are approved. Next to safety, regulations and standards are also there for the user friendliness. Open charge protocols are now adopted throughout Europe and the USA for interoperability. And international roaming and ad hoc payment is recently mandated by the EU Commission. In general, when reaching higher production volumes, the learning advances. Recent improvement in batteries is realized by better chemistry and production tolerances. More automated process control means less weak points and hotspot failures in the cells. And the battery pack is as good as the weakest link in the chain. Also, cost reduction is a result of continuous improvement that comes with economies of scale. In this respect, the recent cost reductions in batteries is a good example. The traction battery production is now overtaking the volume of the cell phone batteries. As a consequence, prices are halved at about every 3 years. Also interesting is the recent German study about the cost price of a Tesla Model 3. Based on the bill of materials and parts countdown, the study found a significant cost reduction. At the calculated 17,000 cost price, the Model 3 seems to be very competitive and profitable. Most TCO calculations point in the direction that at higher volume prices, EVs are the winner. It's illustrative that the new Tesla semi-truck is offered at a lower cost per mile than diesels. Next to mass production, just-in-time supply will be a significant cost reduction factor. Today, battery production is still concentrated in Japan, Korea, China, and North America. To shorten transport distance and time to delivery, production needs to start in Europe too. Governments are pushing to move to a zero-emission transport system in the near future. They have to be in line with their goals of the Paris Climate Agreement. Governmental bodies therefore set mandates for emissions or number of clean vehicles. The Californian Air Resources Board adopted the first zero-emission vehicle regulation in 1990. Current examples are the European Emission Standard and the American EPI fuel economy ratings. And lately, China's offensive new energy vehicle mandate led to market leadership in EVs. These mandates push automakers to continuously improve the energy efficiency to the limits. If mandates become stricter, OEMs have to build zero-emission vehicles to comply to the law. Norway demands zero-emission vehicle sale already in 2025. The Netherlands follows in 2030. Some cities will close the road for polluting cars, trucks and buses even before these dates. It's good to realize that ZEV mandates only make sense with a new energy infrastructure. Currently, the EVs market and product development is more or less a battle between the continents. USA has many innovative product leaders, especially in California. China is the fastest growing in the EV sector and may soon dominate the market as the cost leader. Europe can still be the premium quality leader, but then the industry has to wake up soon. The risk of coming late and losing or non-owning the production base is there. The Chinese company Geely became Daimler's biggest shareholder earlier this year, and Tesla and BYD are looking for expansion of their production base in Europe. On the other hand, some European manufacturers are developing with Chinese joint venture partners. Key words in this global business are a level playing field market and cross-border mobility. Ecology and new economy go hand in hand. Most startups are focused on sustainability. The expectation is that electric mobility will be providing profitable growth in the near future. We are still in the seeding phase with a lot of investments, but soon the harvesting follows. Most new business starts in addition to the existing market. However, substitution will happen. At this moment in time, electrification has extra and high quality employability as a result. Still, the German car industry expects significant job losses due to electrification. But according to auto professor Dudenhöfer, especially Germany will lose its position without it. It's a fact that EVs are the fastest growing in near all automotive segments. Double-digit yearly sales growth of vehicles, material supply and charging are no exceptions. Despite production problems, Model 3 is the most sold premium middle-class sedan in the USA. Regardless car, bus or truck, more and more best-selling vehicles are electric vehicles. Also, in electric car sharing, we see a sharp ramp-up of new mobility as a service companies. This growth is the result of private and government investments, subsidies, or tax exemptions. For newcomers, it's wise to learn from lessons and best practice of front-running regions. A well-balanced policy in which the polluter pays and with general incentives works best. In a transition, everyone has to be able to benefit, otherwise social resistance builds up. The future will not only be electric, but also automatic and connected. As an example, students of the Rotterdam University worked in the following business case. For the new container exchange route at the Port of Rotterdam, transport options were analyzed. A TAS operator will have to take care of clean transport and timely delivery of all containers. Crucial is that efficiency in terms of energy use and the total cost of operation is better than today. The current manned diesel trucks were compared with new electric automated guided trucks. The calculated TAS solution using on-site wind energy is half the cost and zero emission. To come to the end, it will still be a hard battle to leave the oil-based economy behind. But the sector agrees that the future will be electric anyhow. So why wait? The 21st century mobility business needs new visionaries, engineers and entrepreneurs. 230 years after the Dutch professor Strating made the first EV scale model, Heine invented the electric bus wheel and Van Hooijdonk designed the remarkable BMW E3. I thank you very much.